Let's go. All right, Oksana and Kayne. Oh, is Hakoneda staying with his drones? Ooh, Kayne is so good on this map. So good on this map. Good work. Hakoneda has dropped the drones. Scorp Flame from Dennis, standard for him. Scorp Flame from Hakoneda. But boost here gives Dennis Behemoth the edge in Scorp Flame Wars. However, Hakoneda has the edge in terms of being able to drop a motherfucking Tower of Death right the fuck there. And that is going to be a big problem for anyone to deal with. And he's going to be able to take out anything he wants there. So yeah, it's just even, like, just going round and round a missile can be super irritating. It becomes all about the positioning. And the extra, I don't know why Dennis went wheels there. I think that must have been a misclick. I'm pretty sure he would have wanted to go bikes. Things are stalling out. He needs to stall the pads out now. That's good. But yeah, he's not got the good unit distribution. He's forced to go lasers right now. He's able to hold. The bikes coming in for some attack on the half is a bit pointless, really. So he's forced to retreat, and the pads are charging now, though, so this is not ideal. Ooh, I don't know about the Scorp going around there, mate. He wants to get the bikes on the top now. Bikes on the top of that pad. He didn't block. Dennis's blocking was not on point, and he's lost the missile, and he's lost his harvester. Hakoneda with an easy burst missile. Harvester down, and Hakoneda is all over him right now. That early misclick where he went wheels and he meant to go bikes, it's cost him so much, and this is how things can turn against you in Rivals. It's just a great example of how things can just go so wrong. The flames are, where are the flames going? We don't know. Like, it's like he could have tried to kill that, but yeah, he's just losing lasers unnecessarily right there. Well, why are the flames retreating from those flames? They had position and now they're losing out. It's like Dennis's micro is not really there right now, and he needs to get his act together a little bit. First in a long series, though, so there's plenty of time to come back from this. But Hakoneda is all over him at the moment. He has a disadvantage. We haven't really seen a boost or a commander power used by either faction at the moment. Oh, and we've got a stank out. Personally, I think a Scorp would have been a better shout than a stank right there. Like, he's going after the harp. Great. Why? It's not really a priority right now, in my opinion. I mean, he's going to get another half kill, but yeah, so what? Like, he's going to get the missile right now, and it's not really anything that Hakoneda needs it for. Like, I guess he's trying to finance a Kayne tower. Again, the wheels could have got on there. And the flames would have been blocking the stank from getting there. The stank would have had to double back. It's just things like that that would have given him an extra boost there. Harvester's down again. Scorp retreats. Harvester cannot get to a pad. The flames could have gone there and blocked it. If it was me, I would have done that. I would have tried to block the harp. But yeah, he just needs to get on a pad now. The missiles really aren't charging that much. Hakoneda is really got the advantage here. He's got 400 tib, pretty much, over him. And yeah, that just says a lot. And he's going for the harp again, because, you know, why not? But, ooh, he's going for the harp pull. Yeah, he's decided he's got enough money, and I think that's reasonable. Unlike the billionaires of the world, Hakoneda knows when he has enough money. And yeah, that's it. The Kayne Tower's down. Harvest is coming forward to try and block the Scorp. There's nothing that he can do here. 300 more tib at the end of the game. So that was pretty decisive for Hakoneda there. Game 2, R Dog versus Wasim Mamu. Didn't realize R Dog was back, so that's good. You've been watching The Mandalorian. Ah, fair enough. Jesus, excuse me. Wow, this map again. Unusual. Wasim has pulled his half down to the tile there. That's pretty reasonable. And we have dogs out on both sides. APC Solomon from our dog. Wasim again with his slingshot. Going to be so much use. Enjoy that slingshot, bro. Enjoy not using it ever. Enjoy never building it. Such a great unit. Love it so much. But yeah, APC on this map is not great because it takes so fucking long to get anywhere. But the pads are under contention. Ardok is he's moving forward. The pitbull took a reasonable amount of damage to the dogs, actually. But the top pad is definitely going to be won by Wasim. He's transitioned to... He went second missile, and Ardok went second pitbull, and that weren't a good call. But, oh, he's pushing forward to contention. Nice. The dogs are going to get some nice damage on the shocks there. The snipers are redeploying, and the dogs need to get there to hem them in and restrict their options. Snipers again move to the wrong place. He needs to go more snipes. He's going to need to go snipers on the top for right top as well now. See, he's boosting. He's going to take them down. But the sniper's on the top as well. But now he's, how's he going to control the bottom pad? Yeah, that's the problem. He went double snipers, but with the pit bulls out, what's he going to do against that? What is he going to do? He's going to lose the missile. That's what he's going to do. Remember, Wasim's team is 1-0 up. A lot to play for yet. Ardog's first APC rumbles slowly forwards indeed. Very, very slowly forwards indeed. And here come the pits. Look at that one. Look at that one brave little sniper. Yeah, Ardog's just like, fuck it. I'm just going to pull this APC forward as far as I possibly can. And New Yorker's just like, hello. Look at all the APCs. Just like, nope. I'm going to leave now. The Orca wants to pull back. Oh no, Wasim let it take a lot of damage it didn't need to endure right then. Yeah, there was no need for that. In the meantime, there's not really much. I can see what's happening on the top, but it's not really worth commenting on. But he's going to lose that Orca. Going to lose the Orca. That was careless. Is that additional damage that he took against the APC just by sitting there? Ooh, dead. But in the meantime, top pad is secured. I don't think Wasim realizes that that pad is in danger. Two pads secured, the third pad in contention, and Ardog sets a straight missile, and it becomes 1-1. Kane Seth. Oh my god, do I have that moment? Yeah, Kane Seth. And we have a really good map for Kane once again. Are we going to see the tower deployed? This is one of the few maps I can think of where you have the Kane tower in a certain position and it controls the entirety of the pads. But with this one, it is really key to get to the pads first. And Hulkinator has let Dennis get on there. The question is, of course, will Dennis now be able to hold his position? And the answer is no fucking way. Not with double laser against double wheel right now. But yeah, triple level wheel comes out to reinforce. Dennis might actually hold here. He might actually hold here. We're going to see a flame transition. Basically mirror decks for the most part, except there's Stank for Hulkinator and Drone for Dennis. Dennis heard about drones being annoying and he's just like, oh shit, yeah, I want in on that. How can I make Bulldog grind his teeth? I'm going to get some drones, man. So cool. But it's this is fine. I mean, really, for Hulkinator, he's happy for the bikes to play waltzing from the fucking Tilda over there. Because it just lets him position himself pretty well. He's set up quite nicely now. Oh, that wasn't the best draw pod. That wasn't the best draw pod because it's already got whittled down. Look at the blocking. Look at these wheels fly, baby. Yeah, that was not the best position draw pod. I mean, it's not as bad as when people set draw pods to come up next to mutants, which promptly destroy it before it even opens. But it weren't great. So Hulkinator is on the front foot now. And the Scorp Flame Wars are up and kicking off in earnest. The Scorp, in the meantime, did a little bit of damage to the flames. Scorp Prayer is surprisingly reasonably good against chipping down the infantry. The bikes, I think they got a hit on the Scorp tank of Dennis. Dennis on the back foot here. He's got the lasers there, but of course the Scorp is not committing to that. He's trying to push forward, and then he has a nice concertina of flame troops closing in and around that unfortunate flame squad. Dennis's Scorp tank is on its last legs. It's venting oil and exhaust fumes, and basically its carburetor is rattling. It's not looking good. It's shooting the wrong way. It's dead. Yeah. So yeah, basically this is Hulkinator's game to lose at this stage. He's got the Kane tower. There's the Kane tower and there's the surrender. Yeah, Dennis knew it. Dennis knew. He saw that Kane tower come down and he was just like, fuck me, I'm done. Sim against Ardog. And here we go. I like this map. It's a fun little map when you're running Mutant Chuggy as well. Pretty cool. We have Mutant Chuggy. Mutant Chuggy Inferno Phantom. You look at that deck and you think, fuck me, that's an expensive deck. Fucking upper middle class Mandalorian here with this expensive ass deck that us poor people can't afford, you know. And Scorp Flame from Wasim. More traditional. Pretty effective against this. He's got Phantom though, which is going to do well against Inferno, but Inferno Phantom is a bad combination for Phantom alone. The bike's pushing in. Lasers out to deal with it. Already he's decided what I'll do is I'll try and shoot the lasers with bikes. Shockingly, that didn't go especially well. The lasers push forward, more bikes coming out. The bike wars are not going to go R-Dog's way because he has lasers out against him. Although, ooh, Scorp Tank is a game changer there. I don't know why that laser pushing forward there. That was the wrong way around. He wanted to push there. Oh, the Scorp Tank just needs to get to this pad. Nice hit there. Bikes to the top. Scorp Tank holding the bottom. Oh, he could have blocked it there and he didn't, but there we go. Nice. Wasson gets the first missile. He was content to sit there. I think R-Dog could have done something to try and deny these blue bikes getting on the pad up here. But the advantage is basically Wasim's now. It's the games. This is to throw away. Mutants are out. The not otters. We're not like the otters, they say, as they come for you. Don't try and take a shot with Scorps. Also, you know, you need to actually have your flames in position. Oh, Chem Buggy out. All right, the flame now needs to pull back to here. The Scorp needs to push forward. The Scorp is forward. That's fine. More flames to the top. Oh, where's the boost? Okay, so you boost it. If you boost it, you want to move the bloody tank. This is a little tip I've learned during my time playing Rivals. If you're going to boost a unit, it's always good to move it. But in the meantime, the pads are charged. And it's all too late. See, there's the boost. But it was all too late. And Wasson made it look easy. As that R-Dog is no slouch. And like I say, Wasson was an unknown quantity to me. But he's really showing what he can do, you guys. And what he can do is make it 3-1 for his team. Kane Jackson. Strong arm, sorry. Kane Strong Arm. This is the first Strong Arm we've seen on the stream tonight. Reasonable map for Strong Arm. Not great. Oh, okay, Dennis. What are you doing with the Harvester? Doing a little wiggle waggle there. I mean, despite that, he still gets to the pads first. It's fine. And actually, eco-wise, he's actually doing pretty good here. Huckinator a bit soft the mark there, maybe. Scorp Flame versus APC Orca. I feel like Scorp Flame has the advantage here. Scorp takes that APC down with relative ease. And then the flames come along and basically roasty-toasty the missile troops inside. Those dogs doing their good job well. They're being good boys, good robo boys, good blockies. And it looks like Dennis can secure a missile here. But he's being a bit chaotic. He's being a bit try-hard. Oh, he needs to block that Scorp. Nice work. Nice work. He's got the block there. He's done a good job there. He's kept it off the pad. He's got that first missile. That was good play by him. Another hit on the Scorp is not a bad thing. Missiles coming out now. It's going to... Two missiles coming out now. Don't move your missiles. Just focus down the bloody work. You're not going to get the Scorp. And in the meantime, you've just lost that squad. No gain. And now your harvest is going to die. See, it's on such things turn the fates of games. And again, he's moving. Why? Why are you moving? It's like you can't get to the Scorp. You're blocked out. You've lost your harvester. He can afford a Cane Tower now if he wants one. APC is coming out. So he's going to try and get that APC down as far as he can. Power to overwhelm and still get the APC on a pad. He's forgotten to move it. That's kind of important. Oh, this is going to be very important. Can he get on that pad? He's got on the top pad. Oh, unfortunate. Unfortunate. He's lost the missile now, though. Yeah, the Cane Tower is just going to make mincemeat of that APC. He could have had that. The timing was just off. The well-placed Cane Tower. You see what I mean? Like, he lost his half here because he mismicroed his troops. And the loss of the half enabled Huckinator to afford the Cane Tower, which enabled him to win that missile. And now Huckinator is all over Dennis now. The snipers are a last resort and they're not doing well here. He'd be more advised to spend his money going more APCs, frankly. Just try and get on the pads, just hold out for as long as he possibly can. He doesn't have a half, he needs to rebuild one fast, because he's not going to be able to do jack shit against Scorp Flame with no harvester. Look at the margins here. I don't know if Dennis realizes that he doesn't have a half, and if he does, I think he stopped caring. But yeah, he is done. The surrender really should come in here. Bulldog's right, the surrender should come in. There's nothing he can do here. Look at that. The Jackson drop turret drops. The Cane Tower is now going to zap the Jackson turret down. That's what I do. Yeah, there you go. And it becomes a 4-1 gap. It is now match game. R-Dog really needs to bust out a strong performance here. Kane in a fur coat. It's cold out there. Kane is a good choice again on this map. Drop the tower there. You've got control over most of the pads. Wasim is coming with Oksana, Scorp Flame. Traditional. Phantom there will be a good shout to deal with the inevitable drones, because our dog's going to be spanning a butt ton of drones to try and keep this team in the game here. Alright, got the bikes out. A little bit unnecessary, because at the moment this is just going to go well for him. A bit hasty. I don't know why he went bikes, in fairness, because like there was nothing that required it. He had militants and lasers out, and he's just like, yup, I'm going to build some bikes to deal with that. It seems like a sensible solution. Perhaps a misclick. Perhaps he meant to go wheels there. But if it was a misclick again, upon such things do the fate of games fall. Right now, yeah, the drones are going to be a real problem. Lasers are a good shout here. He needs to go lasers again to the top, or a bike to the top. Ooh, okay, this is interesting. He needs bikes or lasers to the top now. Oh, the drones redirected. Get on the pad, buddy. The flames could have blocked. The flames could have blocked. Do a swap. Do a swap on the bottom pad. What's him? Do a swap on the bottom pad. It doesn't matter. He's got it now. But he could just swap that round, and he could have had the missile so much quicker. Like, you're not supposed to be biased, but, you know, it does my heart good to see the drone spam didn't win in that time. But he's going to need to go Scorp now to deal with the Ken Buggy. And now microing the Scorp to deal with the Ken Buggy and trying to dodge the drones is going to be a big deal here. Really going to be an issue here. But he's just steadily taking chip damage to those drones, and their efficacy is being reduced. He, of course, is a little bit pop-capped now, and he's quite happy for it to stay that way. He will be in no rush. Ooh, that's a big drop. I don't know about that. He got it, but that was a big committal of points. I mean, he's been spamming cheap units, so he could afford it. Where are the bikes going? The bikes are just like, bro, yes. Yes, kill me, baby. I have maximum opportunity to destroy me. I want you to destroy me. He's firing on the wrong things again. He's not firing the right way. Our dog's missile. Our dog's got this missile now. Oh, he's pushing forward. This is good. Oh, this is actually a good push. No, block the pad. Oh, he didn't block the pad. Okay, do the swap. Do a swap. He's not swapping. You can swap units on the pads. You don't have to stand there and let bad things happen. Oh, no, move the bikes onto there. Oh, God, just, man. He's firing on the militants. He doesn't want to be doing that. He wants to get on there. That's fine. There's so much he can do. He's good. Like, drone spam is going to happen now. No, why is he retreating? Why are you retreating? Get on there. Yes, he's got it. Nice. He's got it. And there you go. It is done. I wrote that in the wrong way around. 5-1. It is over. But yeah, the micro was not on point there, but the result was all that he needed. So yeah, 5-1. There you go.